you need to size the pumps to ensure that they will operate at optimal efficiency in your project? Have you run into connect addition of water can and water gems which have enhanced system curve tools to help you do this? Well, in this video, I am going to talk about the same. Earlier, you could plot system head curve for constant speed pumps only, but starting with the connect addition of update 1 of OpenFlow's products, that is WaterCat and WaterGems, the system head curve tool has been enhanced to plot the system head curve for variable speed pumps as well, which is an addition to the tool. For the illustration purpose, I am going to open a system head curve for an example model in WaterGems Connect Edition Update 2, which is the latest version at this moment. So these are the pumps, and this is the pump station. So I'll right click on the pump and click on system head curve. So in this, you can view the pump characteristic curve for different pump speeds in the system head curve tool. Select the pump from this dialog box. You can also specify the maximum flow and the number of intervals for which you want to calculate the system head curve. And these are the time steps options available for which you can calculate the system head curve. So you can select the multiple time steps in this case or any case. Okay. So this provides a more accurate and complete illustration of the operating point as a VSP, as you know, changes the speed during the simulation. Okay, so here is the dialog box for show variable speed pump curves. This will be visible only if you're having the variable speed pumps in your model. Okay, so I'll just go on this pump properties. So this is this pump 2 is my variable speed pump, so that is the reason the dialog is visible. So if I'm say, I'm making this to false, and I again click on the system head curves, you will see that the option is not available anymore. Okay. So if you leave this checkbox unchecked, the pump curves will show the pump characteristic curve at full speed of the pump. And if you check on that, then it will show the system head curve for the variable speed of the pump. Okay, so by checking this box, you will be able to view the system head curves at times that you select over here, as well as the pump curve at the relative speed factor calculated at that time step, as can be seen over here. Okay, now we will create system head curves at multiple time steps, let's say 0 hours, 10 hours, and 24 hours. I'll click on this box, show variable speed pump curves, yes, and compute the model. For the visibility, I'll click on show legend. So this will give me the information about the pump definition curve and the system head curve and the relative speed of the pump. The curves which are going down, this is the pump definition curve, and the curves which are going up, these are the system head curves. The pump definition curves are calculated at the relative speed factors at respective hours. Like at 0 hours, relative speed factor is 0.97, and at 24 hours it is 0.971, and at 10 hours it is 1.00. So based on that, these pump definition curves are calculated. The color coding used for both the pump curve and the system head curve, it's same if you notice for each time step. For example, the green color, this is system head curve at 24 hours, and this green color which is going down as well, this is a pump definition curve at 24 hours. At this point, the pump of relative speed factor is obviously 0.97. The operating point of the pump is where the pump definition curve intersects with the system head curve for the 24 hours time steps. Here it is interacting. So the flow of the pump is 600 GPM and the head is 65 feet. However, it is also important to understand that where the system head curve for the 0 hour intersects with the pump curve at 10 hours or 24 hours are essentially meaningless, since the pump doesn't operate at the same relative factors at multiple time steps. Now what I have done is I have created a system head curve only for one time step, that is 0 hour. Okay, so this gray line which you see, it is a full speed pump curve, or relative speed factor is 1.0 in that case. When there are multiple pumps and one of the pumps happened to operate at full speed at some point during the calculation, the gray curve would be replaced by the actual pump curve in that case. So to summarize all these things, so where the system head curve intersects with the pump curve at full speed would give the user an idea of the operating point if such a condition were used to happen at that time stage. So as explained earlier, you can add the legend by show legend over here, and also you can change the visualization of the system head curve by changing multiple options here of the chart options in the system head curve toolbox. Thank you.
If you found this video helpful, please give it a like. If you want to see more such series, consider subscribing to our channel. Thank you, and see you next time.